Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about Letrozole versus Clomiphene. Polycystic ovary syndrome or PCOS is one of the important disorder in the woman which is associated with decreased ovulation in the woman. In such conditions we can give the medications which can increase the ovulation. We have two types of drugs like Letrozole and Clomiphene, both can be used in the PCOS to increase the ovulation. Letrozole is well known with its brand name Femara, whereas Clomiphene is well known with its brand name Clomid. Even both of these drugs are going to increase the ovulation, but still they are acting in a different way. So in this video we are going to discuss the comparisons and differences between Letrozole and Clomiphene. First of all, let us start with the mode of action. How these two drugs are going to act to increase ovulation. Letrozole is one of the drugs which is classified as aromatase inhibitor. It is a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor. So this drug is going to inhibit one of the enzyme aromatase. On the other hand, Clomiphene is one of the SERM, selective estrogen receptor modulator. That means this medication is a modulator which can modulate the activity of estrogen receptors. So it can act as either agonist or antagonist. Therefore, Clomiphene shows estrogenic as well as anti-estrogenic effects. Both of these drugs are going to increase ovulation. Within the body, estrogens like estrone and estradiol are biosynthesized and they can act on hypothalamus and pituitary axis. On the hypothalamus and anterior pituitary, estrogen receptors are expressed. Now, estrogens like estrone and estradiol can bind to these estrogen receptors at hypothalamus and anterior pituitary and they produce a negative feedback mechanism. Because of negative feedback mechanism, they inhibit the release of gonadotropes which reduce the ovulation. Now, these estrogens can be synthesized from the two precursors. One is the androstenedione. This androstenedione is going to be converted into estrone by one of the enzyme aromatase. Similarly, another hormone is the testosterone, which is going to be converted into estradiol by the same enzyme aromatase. Now, Letrozole is a aromatase inhibitor. It can block this conversion so that it can inhibit the synthesis of these estrogens. When these estrogens are not synthesized, their negative feedback mechanism is inhibited. That results in the increased release of gonadotropes. When the gonadotropes are increased, it can increase the ovulation. In this way, Letrozole can increase the ovulation by inhibiting the production of estrogens. Now, Clomiphene acts in a different way. Clomiphene is a SERM. It is a selective estrogen receptor modulator. And at the hypothalamus as well as at the anterior pituitary, it can block the estrogen receptors. And when these receptors are blocked, the estrogens cannot activate these receptors, so that the negative feedback mechanism is again inhibited. So this results in the increased release of gonadotropes, that is follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. These two hormones can act on the ovary to induce the ovulation. In this way, Clomiphene can also increase the ovulation. So both Letrozole and Clomiphene can increase the ovulation, but they are acting in different way. Letrozole can reduce the estrogen production, thereby inhibit the negative feedback mechanism on hypothalamus and anterior pituitary. Whereas Clomiphene blocks the estrogen receptors, thereby can increase the production of gonadotropes, resulting in the stimulation of ovulation. Second one, effect on estrogen levels. Letrozole is one of the aromatase inhibitor, so it can reduce the estrogen synthesis. So with use of Letrozole, we can observe the decreased levels of estrone and estradiol within the body. On the other hand, Clomiphene is a estrogen receptor modulator. So this drug is not affecting the estrogen levels. Instead, it is going to affect the actions of estrogen. So Clomiphene can produce anti-estrogenic effects, which results in the increased release of gonadotropes like follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone, which further increase the ovulation. This is one of the beneficial effects that can be observed with Clomiphene. But this medication can also produce estrogenic effects, which results in increased uterine weight. So here both Letrozole and Clomiphene are different. Letrozole is mainly reducing the estrogen levels, whereas clomiphene can produce estrogenic as well as anti-estrogenic effects. Third one is the clinical indications. Letrozole can be used in various conditions, particularly it can be used as an adjuvant in the treatment of breast cancer in postmenopausal women. It can also be used as a first-line agent as well as second-line agent in the advanced stage of breast cancer in postmenopausal women. And the third clinical indication is used as off-label purpose. It can be used for the treatment of infertility in the women with PCOS. On the other hand, clomiphene is particularly indicated to induce the ovulation. It is a SERM, estrogen receptor modulator, and it can be used to induce the ovulation in anovulatory women. So here letrozole can be used for different conditions, whereas clomiphene is only indicated for ovulation. Fourth one is the ovarian hyperstimulation. Clomiphene is one of the medication on cyclic use. It can stimulate the ovaries, and when it is combined with gonadotrophs, it further produces ovarian stimulation, resulting in ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, OHSS. Even it is a rare condition, but when this clomiphene is repeatedly used, otherwise it is used in combination with gonadotrophs, it can produce ovarian hyperstimulation, resulting in the increased weight gain, increased ovary size, along with abdominal distension, abdominal pain. All this can be observed with ovarian hyperstimulation. On the other hand, letrozole does not show ovarian hyperstimulation. Instead, it can reduce this action because of decreased estrogen levels. So here letrozole is having some advantages over clomiphene. Fifth one, multiple pregnancy. This is the another disadvantage of clomiphene. Clomiphene is having the long half-life. So because of long half-life, on cyclic use, this drug can be accumulated within the body, which can act on the ovaries to produce multifollicular ovulation. So it can release the eggs from both of the ovaries, resulting in multifollicular ovulation, which may result in the birth of twins. So multiple births are observed with clomiphene. On the other hand, letrozole is not showing the multiple births because this drug only produces monofollicular ovulation. So here letrozole is having more advantage compared with clomiphene because it does not produce multiple pregnancy. Sixth one is visual dysfunction. With the use of clomiphene, visual disturbances can be observed and people may observe blurring, spots, flashes. These visual disturbances are not observed with letrozole. Seventh one is bone mineral density. Here letrozole shows its effect. Because of decreased estrogen levels, letrozole can increase the bone resorption, thereby can reduce the bone mass and increase the bone loss. So bone mineral density is reduced by letrozole, whereas clomiphene, because of estrogenic effects on the bones, it can reduce the bone loss and it can reduce the osteoporosis. So bone mineral density is increased with clomiphene, whereas decreased with letrozole. So letrozole is having one of the disadvantages of reduced bone mineral density, and in the woman with significant bone loss, letrozole should be carefully used. Eighth one is the birth rate. Here both of these drugs are going to increase the ovulation, but the live birth rate is more with letrozole compared with clomiphene. And clomiphene can increase the abortion and multiple pregnancy, so birth rates are somewhat less with the clomiphene. Ninth one is the doses. For the treatment of infertility, letrozole can be used at a dose of 2.5 to 7.5 mg given for 5 days as one cycle. On the other hand, clomiphene can be used at a dose of 50 mg once daily for 5 days as one cycle. So letrozole can be used at low dose compared with clomiphene. So these are the various comparisons and differences between the two drugs, letrozole and clomiphene, which are used to induce ovulation in the woman with polycystic ovary syndrome. Letrozole is having some advantages. It can be used at low dose. It cannot produce multiple pregnancy. It is not producing any ovarian hyperstimulation, and live birth rates are more in the letrozole. But it is having one of the disadvantages is that it can reduce the bone mineral density, so it can increase the risk of bone loss. And clomiphene is the old generation drug that can be used to induce ovulation in the polycystic ovary syndrome, but it is having few of the disadvantages like multiple pregnancy, ovarian hyperstimulation, and visual disturbances. So that's all about these two drugs, letrozole versus clomiphene. That's for today. I hope this video is useful to you. If you really like this video, please subscribe to our channel, share this video with your friends, post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.